Good day, brothers and sisters. This is the Daily Manna Extract for the 3rd of December 2021. Shall we pray? Our Father, we worship and bless your name for the great and wonderful things you've been doing in our lives. You are a mighty God. You are a powerful God. There is no circumstances, there's no situation that is beyond your touch, that is beyond your reach, that is beyond solutions from you. Lord, I lift up, oh God, as many today, hearing the sound of my voice, those who are going through one pain or the other, one challenge or the other, one situation or the other, one delay or the other, I pray today you will show forth in their life. You will wipe away their tears. You will turn things around in the life of your children, even today, in the name of Jesus. As we look into your word, stir up our faith. Move us to believe you more. Thank you, because I believe you have answered. In Jesus' mighty name I pray, amen. We're considering the topic 100% accuracy. 100% accuracy. Our text is taken from Mark chapter 7 verse 31 to 37. And again, departing from the coast of Tyre and Sidon, he came unto the Sea of Galilee, through the midst of the coast of Decapolis. And they bring unto him one that was deaf, and had an impediment of speech, and they beseech him to put his hand upon him. And he took him aside from the multitude, and put his fingers into his ears, and spit, and touched his tongue, and looking up to heaven, he sighed, and saith unto him, Ephphatha, that is, be opened. And straightway his ears were opened, and the string of his tongue was loosed, and he spake plain, and he charged them that they should tell no man. But the more he charged them, so much the more a great deal they published it, and were beyond measure astonished, saying, He hath done all things well. He maketh both the deaf to hear and the dumb to speak. A key verse is in verse 37. And we are beyond measure astonished, saying, He hath done all things well. He maketh both the deaf to hear and the dumb to speak. Medical science has no doubt done so much in the area of providing healing and cure to different ailments and medical conditions. Every year, different breakthroughs are recorded as new discoveries are made to provide solutions to sicknesses and medical conditions that had previously defied solutions. Billions of dollars are committed to researches, trainings, trials, and procurement of medical facilities that are intended to help improve the practice of medicine and the health of people. With all these breakthroughs and commendable sacrifices of our medical personnel, we, however, know that medicine has not been able to record a 100% success rate in all situations. Several factors are no doubt responsible for this, but then it reveals the limitation of human ingenuity. As it is with medicine, so it is with other fields of human endeavors. This is where the healing ministry of Christ stands out. No case brought before him has ever defied his power and authority. From the text, he performed an outstanding and astonishing miracle on a deaf and dumb man. He never rejected any situation as being beyond his power. None ever came to him and left disappointed. He always did all things well. We need to remind ourselves that Jesus is the same as he was when he walked the streets of Galilee. The same miracles he performed then, he still does now, even in greater measures. He did not fail then, and still has never failed, and will never fail. He has perfect solutions to all human problems. Where the efforts of men end, there his ability starts. What we need then is absolute trust and confidence in him. There is no situation that we bring to him in faith that defy his power. Thought for the day. He does all things well. Amen. As we look at various solutions that have been brought by men to cater and to solve some of the diseases and the challenges of health today, we see limitation in the solutions brought by men. Most of the vaccines in the past that have been brought by men to cater for some deadly ailments have had limitations in one way or the other, because men are limited in bringing solutions to problem. But God, in his infinite mercy, has perfect solution to the problem of man. If we trust the Lord today, if we believe in the Lord today, only believe. Once you believe, once I believe, there is nothing God cannot do for you, for me. Look at the children of Israel. They were faced with mountain. They were faced with a Pharaoh that will not let them go. God wrought his wonders. God performed miracles until the point that the magicians of Pharaoh said, "This is the finger of God." Pharaoh have to let them go. And while they were on their way going, Pharaoh thought about it. Why do I let them go? I need to pursue after them. When the children of Israel advanced to get to the promised land, they met the Red Sea. And as we pass through this Red Sea, the Lord once again showed forth for them. The Red Sea parted left to right, and the water became an heap on the left, on the right, showing us the power of God. He never fails. He cannot fail. Those who we are buried in scriptures had their children, not just an ordinary child, but they had spectacular, miraculous children the Lord gave to them. He never failed then. He cannot fail now. Look at men and women who had challenges in the scriptures. They went to the Lord. They prayed to the Lord, and the Lord wrought wonders in their life. A man like Jabez, he was born with sorrow. The name Jabez carried sorrow all over him. Jabez cried to the Lord. He said, "Oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed and enlarge my cause, and that thy hand might be with me, that it may not grieve me." The Bible said the Lord granted him that which he requested, and Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. Look at Jehoshaphat. They were faced with threat from seven nations, but they trust in the Lord. The Lord sent an ambushment to the camp of the enemies, and they began to fight themselves. Look at Hezekiah. He was faced by the threat from the Assyrians, and he went to the Lord, and he cried to the Lord. All those nations that came together, a confederacy against Israel, helping the Assyrians to achieve their aim. When Hezekiah cried to the Lord, the Lord sent just an angel to the camp of Assyria, and 185,000 soldiers were destroyed in a night. That same God is still alive. No matter what you are going through today, the threat from the enemies, the threat from wicked men, wicked women, all the arrows being shot by the enemy, if we trust in the Lord today, if we believe in the Lord today, what he did in days gone by is able to still do even more today. Look at the New Testament. The disciples were in the ship, and the storm arose, storm that almost want to wreck them apart, that almost want to end their ministry, that almost want to end their life. Maybe you are going through storm today. Storms in your life, delay in various aspects of your life, delay in getting married, delay in in having children, delay in getting a job, delay, several delays in your life, and you are just thinking, look at the storms in my life. Despite the fact I'm serving the Lord, I believe in Jesus. Jesus Christ was in the ship with them, and there were storms in their life. The fact that you are serving God, the fact that you believe in Jesus, does not take away the storm. But one thing is sure, if Jesus Christ is in the boat with you, you will not sink. That problem will not consume you. That sickness you are having right now, that sickness is not unto death. That calamity that befell your family, the Lord is going to turn again your captivity. The Lord will wipe away your tears. That pain, that penury, that situation, that challenge in your life is not beyond the reach of God. It's not beyond what God can do. As you trust in the Lord today, the disciples cried and say, Master, carest thou not that we perish? And he rebuked the wind. Every wind in your life, every storm in your life, every boisterous circumstances, challenges in your life, by the power of God, I decree, peace be still in the name of Jesus. When Jesus made that declaration, the Bible said there was a great calm. The storm ceased. The wind ceased, and the disciples had peace within them. His peace have come to you today. Blind Bartimaeus had been blind for many years. When he heard Jesus passing, he cried aloud, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy upon me. He came. He had compassion on him. If you cry to God today, if you pray to God today with faith in your heart, with belief in your heart, he will touch you today. And his touch will bring a miracle in your life in the name of Jesus. That woman with issue of blood 12 years, she has spent all she had. She has met many physicians, but the problem continued to grow worse. She met with Jesus. She said, if I can just touch the hem of his garment, I shall be whole. She touched, and the blood dried up immediately. Brethren, God is still alive. God still doeth wonders beyond measure even today. If we trust him, if we believe in John chapter 21, there are many miracles that were done by Jesus Christ, John 21, 25, and there are also many other things which Jesus did, the which, if they should be written everyone, I suppose that even the world itself could not contain the books that should be written. Amen. If he can do all of this for them in days gone by, why do you think your problem is beyond God? That challenge you have is not beyond God. That circumstances you have is not beyond God. It does things 100% accurate. In your life, it will bring total healing. Acts chapter 10, I want to read there from verse 38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. The question is, why is it that we see not our signs today? Why is it that the result that they got in many years gone by, we don't get the result today? The psalmist had that question. He asks in Psalm 74, verse 9, we see not our signs. There is no more any prophet, neither is there any among us that knoweth how long. O God, how long shall the adversary reproach? Shall the enemy blaspheme thy name forever? Why withdrawest thou thy hand, even thy right hand? Plug it out of thy bosom. For God is my King of old, working salvation in the midst of the earth. The Lord said he will show forth his wonders again. He will do great things for you and for me. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. These are the days of his power. His power is coming again. His powerful work is going to be shown to us today again. John chapter 14, verse number 12. John, I want to read there from chapter 14, verse 12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. What an assurance today we have. And the miracles of days gone by, as we believe the Lord today, the Lord will perform it through you and also in you, in the name of Jesus. Just trust the Lord. Just believe the Lord. What he said he will do, God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. As you trust him today, as you present your needs to God today, he will bring it to pass. I said he will bring it to pass. Open your mouth at this time and begin to talk to the Lord. Tell him that need. Tell him that desire. Tell him that challenge in your life. You must pray. Push through prayers. Pray until something happens. Pray until you stir heaven. Pray until the situation is undone. Pray until you are soundly healed. Pray until you are strong and healthy. Whatever the challenge in your life, brothers and sisters, if you can take it to God in prayers, if you can conquer on your knees, you will see the physical manifestation. Pray, Lord, look at this challenge. Look at this problem. Look at this difficulty. Show forth, O God. If you can succeed on your knees, you will conquer everywhere. Pray, Lord, visit me today. Turn my life around today. You the same yesterday, today, and forever. What you did in days gone by, you are still able. You are still efficacious to get those things done today. Lord, do it in my life. Open your mouth and pray. Present that need to God, that challenge to God, that impossible situation, present it to God. He is able. He will do it for you. In Jesus' name, we pray. Father, I come to you today. I present that brother, that sister, that family into your able hands. Whatever the yoke, whatever the mountain, whatever the challenge, whatever the difficulty, show forth your power right now. Intervene, break the yoke, set them free even today in the name of Jesus. I cut off the hand of the enemy from your life. I cut off every chain they have used to lock you up. I break the chain by the power in the name of Jesus. You are free. You are delivered. Go and enjoy the freedom the Lord has brought to you today. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. The Lord bless you.